Greetings, everyone, with Eddie Olczyk, Ray Ferraro in just a moment. I'm Mike Emmerich, and we have a team tonight that is coming off a win. Probably feel pretty good about themselves. What do you tell them?
Well, you tell them, let's play the same way we did in the prior game, Doc. They did everything that they wanted to get accomplished. They managed to puck extremely well. They got timely goals. They played really well without the puck in their own zone. Let's worry about what we can do, not necessarily what the other team's strengths are.
The Oilers got to stick to the game plan here tonight, Doc. They played a real good team game in their prior win. One of the reasons for that, they had great communication both on and off the ice. Let's see if that continues here tonight. Okay, so let's look at the starting goaltenders for the game. Hopefully his team will give him more support than they did last time, and I'm sure that the coach has spoken with him about bouncing back because it was a decisive loss. Steve Mason is a big man in goal, 6'4", over 215 pounds, a right-hand catching netminder from Oakville, Ontario. All he did his rookie year in Columbus was lead the NHL in shutouts with 10. That also got him the Calder Trophy for Rookie of the Year. We are ready for the first faceoff of the night. Monahan's the starting center for Calgary. Neely's opposite him for the Oilers. And the faceoff unleashes a lot of memories for us, and some new ones about to be made ahead. Got it at the point. Cranks a blast! Piece of a rebound! Well, he'll pay for that. One into another. Looks like he arrived. So, as predicted, we have a fight here.
All players have a role, Doc. Two things, accept and execute. He certainly did that.
I can't say I was exactly ready for this. I was halfway through a drink of water before the gloves go down, and they're trying to inject them.
And it's over with one last resounding punch. But what did you think of it?
I thought it was pretty even throughout, but at the end, certainly you have to give the nod to the big punch.
More times than not, you drop your gloves like that, you're going to spend at least 5 minutes in the box.
Of that, it looks like we might have some more here.
Well, when you back like that,
and the tone is set early here as things get rough. They use their fists and got a fistful, five each for fighting.
These games don't come along very often anymore where they're chippy, aggressive, over the line a lot of times with way too many penalties.
There's so many ways you can get banged up in a fight here. He's not looking so great right now.
Chance to rest for 5 minutes.
A little under 3 minutes gone. Still scoreless. Edmonton's got that win. Wow, what a hit. And they square off.
Well, that was not a good hit at all. Now somebody's coming to the aid of a fallen teammate.
You knew it was going to come to this pretty quickly as the two teams play. It's always physical and the temperature gets.
And this fight is over. What a way to finish it.
It is much better to give than receive. Trust me.
Much safer up here with you, Doc, in the booth. 5 minutes for fighting for those guys.
Won that face off. Now what? Goal. He'll pay for that.
will have 5 minutes to get back dressed and get ready to go again at some point.
The Oilers win that faceoff.
Occurred a while ago. He will not return.
Vegas in their own end in possession.
In the slot, he scores two straight goals. Just over 3 minutes to go here in the first. Edmonton's racking up the goals. A four-goal advantage for them.
Oilers goal.
Terrific face-off win. And that's one of them. 14.
From the bench for quite some time. Just heard that he will not be back today. Guys?
Edmonton's won that football game. Number 74.
Prevailed again on the face-off.
Two, he scores. Not much time left, but enough for that one.
period, you have momentum going into the locker room.
Period two is underway. Let's see if something happened during the first. He scores! Yet again, a big night gets even larger.
He had people chasing him down on a breakaway, but he found a way to score. Talbot's reflexes usually are able to catch up to something like this, but Eddie, that's a perfect shot, really accurate, just off the inside of the post.
Edmonton's got an enormous lead, and it's in the second period. Hopefully, they don't go daydreaming. Another good job in the faceoff circle. One of many today. He just keeps adding to a memorable night with another goal.
He looked to be cherry picking in behind the defense, and it worked. He found himself on a breakaway.
The goalie's in perfect position here. Just not perfect enough. This is a really accurate shot.
The Oilers have gotten another goal on a night of many goals. What a satisfying night for them, and their coach won't have much to say.
Oilers goal.
Let's just see before the second period's over if there can be any kind of resistance. They won the faceoff.
Individual effort while on his knees surprised the goaltender and he scored. A think when he takes a look at this on video, he's going to see he was in really good position, and he just wasn't able to stop a perfect shot.
The Oilers have gotten another goal on a night of many goals. What a satisfying night for them, and their coach won't have much to score.
By number 14, by number 42.
In the second half of the game that they might be able to change direction and get a little momentum going. That's easier said than done, as they've been outworked almost everywhere tonight.
Good shooting place. Score! He got hired with that shot.
Him more options. That's exactly what happened on this play.
They all count on the board for the same, but he gave everything he had on that. Just couldn't quite get there.
The Oilers have built an enormous lead and some wonderful confidence here. The coach probably won't have to say much at the end of this second period.
Mission goal scored by number 14.
Breakaway!
This is a good point to hear from Ray Ferraro.
Everly's had several opportunities to shoot the one-timer. He's got an excellent release. Eventually, it pays off.
That's good, Ray. I think he sure has his fans out there. Entering the third period, based on the first two, what are you expecting to happen?
Edmonton's been terrific through two periods of play. They can't sit back now, though. I'm expecting a third period push from the opposition.
Period three has begun. Take a look at the scoreboard. And remember in the past, big comebacks. Shot. He got a piece of that one.
You want to score goals, you have to go to this area.
Down to ringside we go yet again. Ray, what you thinking?
Calgary's defensive play has been atrocious. It's like they've never played together. Their goaltender's the only guy keeping the puck out of the net.
Thanks, Ray. You know, they've had some great moments before. Maybe they will return on this ice surface in this game tonight.
Shelled off, but he doesn't cover it all, and it ends up behind him.
Edmonton's goal has taken them to an even larger lead on a night that they have had the offense going. Third period of play.
Oilers score.
Chipped off the board. 74. In a half.
Right there in the low slot, it doesn't waste any time snapping that off.
How Ovid's done all that he can do and able to stop this shot, but it's just a perfect delivery into the top of the net.
Edmonton's goal has built an even bigger lead. We're in the third period. For the opposition, at least that is fortunate. The Oilers win that neutral zone faceoff.
Guy number 74.
Shot.
Another
goal. Going. Third period of play.
Another face-off win. Four. Just
number
like his team, he's winning everything. He's
eight.
Strong save. Oh, just by being so close to that, this is all a reactionary save.
And here again is Ray.
Thanks, guys. This has been a wonderful night for him. Every time he's had the puck, he's been able to find open ice, and whenever he's had the puck, it's not stayed on his stick very long.
Thanks, Ray. Yeah, he has been remarkable in this game tonight. Fun to watch. The Oilers win. Big hit. Possession gone.
That hit might rattle a few teeth.
Good place to shoot from. Built an even bigger lead. We're in the third period. For the opposition, at least that is fortunate. The Oilers with a center ice faceoff win.
14, assisted by number 14. Shot.
Edmonton's goal has taken them to an even larger lead on a night that they have had the offense going. Third period of play.
Oilers
with a win at
number 22.
In the slot.
Number 14.
Driving toward that net. Outstanding save. What magic to even get the shot over. Nice work by Neely.
Good night.